The Chantry teaches us that it is the hubris of men which brought the Darkspawn into our world. The mages had sought to usurp heaven, but instead, they destroyed it. They were cast out, twisted and cursed by their own corruption. They returned as monsters, the first of the Darkspawn. They became a blight upon the lands, unstoppable and relentless. The Dwarven kingdoms were the first to fall, and from the deep roads, the Darkspawn drove at us again and again, until finally we neared annihilation. Came. Men and women from every race, warriors and mages, barbarians and kings, the Grey Wardens sacrificed everything to stem the tide of darkness and prevail. It has been 4 centuries since that victory, and we have kept our vigil. We have watched and waited for the Darkspawn to return. But those who once called us heroes have forgotten. We are few now, and our warnings have been ignored for too long. Seen with my own eyes what lies on the horizon. Maker, help us all.
Greetings. It's gone!
How do you do?
Greetings.
Greetings.
Charmed.
Greetings.
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 On a cliff overlooking the dark waters of Lake Kalinhad stands the tower fortress that is home to the Circle of Magi. This tower is the only place in Ferelden where mages may study their art among others of their kind. Within the high stone walls, the Circle practices its magic and trains apprentices in the proper use of their powers. But the Circle Tower is as much a prison as a refuge. The ever-vigilant Templars of the Chantry watch over all mages, constantly alert for any sign of corruption. This gilded cage is the only world you know. Found to be sensitive to magic at a young age, you were torn from your family and grafted here as an apprentice. Now, that apprenticeship is nearly over. All that remains is the final test, the harrowing.
Magic exists to serve man, and never to rule over him. Thus spoke the prophet Andraste as she cast down the Tevinter Imperium, ruled by mages who had brought the world to the edge of ruin. Your magic is a gift, but it's also a curse. For demons of the Dream Realm, the Fade, are drawn to you, and seek to use you as a gateway into this world.
This is why the harrowing exists. The ritual sends you into the Fade, and there you will face a demon, armed with only your will.
Know this, apprentice. If you fail, we Templars will perform our duty. You will die. This is Lyrium, the very essence of magic, and your gateway into the Fade.
The harrowing is a secret out of necessity, child. Every mage must go through this trial by fire. As we succeeded, so shall you. Keep your wits about you, and remember the Fade is a realm of dreams. The spirits may rule it, but your own will is real.
The apprentice must go through this test alone, First Enchanter. You are ready.
Right.
Someone else thrown to the wolves. As fresh and unprepared as ever. It isn't right that they do this, the Templars. Not to you, me, anyone. It's always the same. But it's not your fault. You're in the same boat I was, aren't you? Allow me to welcome you to the Fade. You can call me... well, Mouse. No, I don't remember anything from... before. The Templars kill you if you take too long, you see. They figure you failed, and they don't want something getting out. That's what they did to me, I think. I have no body to reclaim. And you don't have much time before you end up the same. Don't waste time with that talk. You don't want to end up like this. There's something here, contained, just for an apprentice like you. You have to face the creature, a demon, and resist it, if you can. That's your way out. Or your opponents, if the Templars wouldn't kill you. A test for you, a tease for the creatures of the Fade. Question for those in the tower. Maybe you'll be lucky enough to ask. Maybe someday, so will I. There are others here, other spirits. They will tell you more, maybe help, if you can believe anything you see. I'll follow, if that's all right. My chance was long ago, but you may have a way out. A dangerous spirit is not far. Don't go near it unless you're ready to fight. Dangerous to be out in the open like this. Not that hiding helps much in the Fade. I missed my chance, so I became small, unnoticeable. I hide from the bigger things, learn from the smaller things. There are places you can hide where the shadows go on forever. You stay there long enough, and the shadows begin to creep inside of you. I don't know how long it's been. Forever, maybe. That is what happens to the physical bodies of apprentices who fail. They'd kill every mage if they could. All the Templars see in magic is danger. And they don't just use the harrowing. If you learn a little too much, they'll label you a blood mage and kill you on sight. True mages like you know that the power you hold is a gateway to greater things, a potential they can never hope to contain. Be turned into an emotionless freak? That is what it is, you know? To never dream, never feel. Even demons abhor them. But I suppose that is the trade-off. They can't be possessed, as if that is worse than losing yourself. You don't want to lose yourself here. Being nothing would be easier than this. Yes. Horrible. You'll find out for yourself soon enough. Maybe you'll say the same thing to yourself one day. is where the test will take place. The creature can be anywhere, but it manifests there. Another spirit this way. It never seemed equal to its name to me.
Another mortal thrown into the flames and left to burn, I see. Your mages have devised a cowardly test. Better you were pitted against each other to prove your mettle with skill, than to be sent unarmed against a demon. The first sent here for such testing, nor shall you be the last, I suspect. That you remain means you have not yet defeated your hunter. I wish you a glorious battle to come. I am Valor, a warrior spirit. I hone my weapons in search of the perfect expression of combat. Is that what your test is called? I know little of your mortal ways. I do know that a demon has been called, and told that a meal awaits. It will not, cannot leave, until one of you is dead. They are brought into being by my will. I understand that in your world, mages are the only ones who can will things into being. Those mortals who cannot must lead such hollow, empty lives. Without a doubt, in this realm, everything that exists is the expression of a thought. Do you think these blades be steel? The staves be wood? Do you believe they draw blood? A weapon is a single need for battle, and my will makes that need reality. Do you truly desire one of my weapons? I will give one to you, if you agree to duel me first. Valor shall test your mettle as it should be tested. If I believe you capable of slaying the demon, I will stop the duel and give you the staff. If I find you unworthy, I will slay you. I trust those rules are simple enough to remember, mortal. As you wish, mortal. Do you understand the rules I explained to you? Our duel begins now. Fight with the...
You!
Your strength is sufficient to the task. The staff is yours. May you find glory in all your achievements, mortal. You have Valor's star. There is nothing else I can do for you.
Cautious. There is another spirit here. Not the one hunting you, but still.
So, you are the mortal being hunted. And the small one? Is he to be a snack for me?
I don't like this. He's not going to help us. We should go.
No matter. The demon will get you eventually. And perhaps there will even be scraps left.
It's a demon. Maybe even more powerful than the one chasing after you.
Be gone. Surely you have better things to do than bother sloth, mortal. Oh, I tire of you already. I am a spirit of sloth. Yes, a creature of the Fade. Unlike yourself, mortals are ever the visitors here. Still, you serve your function. Only the mortals like yourself are truly annoying. immortal with power and will. The sort of creature that some spirits hunger for. I might be inclined for such a meal myself. It would be interesting to see the mortal world through your eyes, live inside your form. But I'm disinclined to begin such a struggle. As you mortals might term it, but not all demons are demons. Worry about the one hunting you. You have a very nice staff. Why do you need me? Go, use your weapon, since you have earned it. Be valorous.
He looks powerful. It might be possible that he could teach you to be like him.
Like me? You mean teach the mortal to take this form? Why? Most mortals are too attached to their forms to learn the change. You, on the other hand, little one, might be a better student. You let go of the human form years ago.
I don't think I'd make a very good bear. How would I hide?
I have faced more in this place than you can imagine. Fear is just one more thing. But you are right. Hiding doesn't help. I'm sorry, it's the Fade. It changes you. I'll try. I'll try to be a bear. If you'll teach me.
That's nice. But teaching is so exhausting. Away with you now.
I told you he wasn't going to help us.
I can't. You have so much to learn about the Fade, little mortal. You wish to learn my form, little one? Then I have a challenge for your friend. Answer 3 riddles correctly, and I will teach you. Fail, and I will devour you both. The decision is yours. Truly? Oh. This gets more and more promising. My first riddle is this. I have seas with no water. Coasts with no sand, towns without people, mountains without land. What am I? Correct. Let's move on. The second riddle. I'm rarely touched, but often held. If you have wit, you'll use me well. What am I? Are you even trying? The answer is a tongue. Time to feast. So, you are the mortal being hunted, and the small one, is he to be a snack for me?
I don't like this. He's not going to help us.
No matter. The demon will get you, eventually. And perhaps there will even be scraps left. Help you? Nothing can help you. Be gone. Surely you have better things to do than bother Sloth, mortal. Oh, I tire of you already. You have a very nice staff. Why do you need me? Go, use your weapon, since you have earned it. Be valorous.
He looks powerful. It might be possible that he could teach you to be like him.
Like me? You mean teach the mortal to take this form? Why? Most mortals are too attached to their forms to learn the change. You, on the other hand, little one, might be a better student. You let go of the human form years ago.
I don't think I'd make a very good bear. How would I hide?
It's true. I am quite powerful in this form, when I wish to be.
I welcome the opportunity, if it is my choice. The mages in the tower are quick to volunteer others, as you well know. I'll try. I'll try to be a bear, if you'll teach me.
That's nice. But teaching is so exhausting. Away with you now.
I told you he wasn't going to help us.
I am a spirit of sloth. Yes, a creature of the Fade. Unlike yourself, mortals are ever the visitors here. Still, you serve your function. Only the mortals like yourself are truly annoying. Many mortals dream. They come here often, but you are not one of those. You are aware, a mortal with power and will. The sort of creature that some spirits hunger for. I might be inclined for such a meal myself. It would be interesting to see the mortal world through your eyes, live inside your form. But I'm disinclined to begin such a struggle. Indeed. Now, what do you want with me? You wish to learn my form, little one? Then I have a challenge for your friend. Answer 3 riddles correctly, and I will teach you. Fail, and I will devour you both. The decision is yours. Truly? Well, this gets more and more promising. My first riddle is this. I have seas with no water, coasts with no sand, towns without people, mountains without land. What am I? Correct. Let's move on. The second riddle. I'm rarely touched, but often held. If you have wit, you'll use me well. What am I? Yes, your witty tongue. Fair enough. One more try, shall we? Often will I spin a tale, never will I charge a fee. I'll amuse you an entire eve. But alas, you won't remember me. What am I? You are correct. Rather apropos here in the Fade, no? But you've won my challenge and proven yourself an amusing distraction. So, I shall teach you my form. Now, listen carefully.
Like this? Am I a bear? It feels heavy.
Close enough. Go, then, and defeat your demon, or whatever you intend to do. I grow weary of your mortal prattling.
There is a spirit of rage.
And so it comes to me at last. Soon I shall see the land of the living with your eyes, creature. You shall be mine. body and soul. They are welcome to try. So this creature is your offering, Mouse. Another plaything as per our arrangement.
I'm not offering you anything. I don't have to help you anymore.
Oh. And after all those wonderful meals we have shared, now suddenly the mouse has changed the rules.
I'm not a mouse now, and soon I won't have to hide. I don't need to bargain with you.
We shall see.
When you came, I hoped that maybe you might be able to, but I never really thought any of you were worthy. You made me believe in you. You're a true mage. One of the few. The others, they never had a chance. The Templars set them up to fail, like they tried with you. I regret my part in it. But you have shown me that there is hope.